straight. I built tall, never capped in space.
I won't stop till I hear him say, in my veins, I've been driving this train. Years in this lane, there's no stopping this flame. Cause I came to the game and I changed it to play. How I like, rearranged it to my own domain. Yeah, I got what it takes, made lots of mistakes. Taking shots, skipping breaks, feeling lost, feeling great. Popping off, singing straight, never stopped, never changed. All the squad here to play and I've got something to say, yeah.
I work hard each and every day. I get lost in the words I say. I don't push pods, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change. I withdraw on the things I make. I turn flaws into flawless traits. I build tall, never capped in space.
I won't stop till I hear him say, man, I'm up again. I got tired eyes, need a cup of blend. That's right, in the AM, that's my only friend. No light, just the sun coming up on the horizon. I lose track of time, yeah, I move fast and climb. A new class divine, yeah, true passion shines. And I'm through passing time, I choose stacking dimes. You snooze half the time while I move passing by.
I work hard each and every day. I get lost in the words I say. I don't push pause, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change. I withdraw on the things I make. I turn flaws into flawless traits. I build tall, never capped in space.
I won't stop till I hear him say, in my veins, I've been driving this train. Years in this lane, there's no stopping this flame. Cause I came to the game and I changed it to play. How I like, rearranged it to my own domain. Yeah, I got what it takes, made lots of mistakes. Taking shots, skipping breaks, feeling lost, feeling great. Popping off, singing straight, never stopped, never changed. All the squad here to play and I've got something to say, yeah.
I work hard each and every day. I get lost in the words I say. I don't push pods, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change. I withdraw on the things I make. I turn flaws into flawless traits. I build tall, never capped in space.
I won't stop till I hear him say, I'm up again. I got tired eyes, need a cup of blend. That's right, in the AM, that's my only friend. No light, just the sun coming up on the horizon. I lose track of time, yeah, I move fast and climb. A new class divine, yeah, true passion shines. And I'm through passing time, I choose stacking dimes. You snooze half the time while I move passing by.
I work hard each and every day. I get lost in the words I say. I don't push pause, no, I push play. I won't stop till I make a change. I withdraw on the things I make. I turn flaws into flawless traits. I build tall, never capped in space.
I won't stop till I hear him say,
ice in my veins. I've been driving this train, years in this lane. There's no stopping this flame, cause I came to the game and I changed it to play how I like, rearranged it to my own domain. Yeah, I got what it takes, made lots of mistakes, taking shots, skipping breaks, feeling lost, feeling great, popping off, singing straight, never stopped, never changed, all the squad here to play.
Thank you for tuning in here live on Beaufort Tone. We got the boys game, Etoile Black versus Valerie Clarie. The crowd is live, the band is lit as we get ready for tip-off. Look like we're having a problem with the clock here. And you got that squared away. Pass to Elijah Mathis. Gabe Leggett, and on the outside, the man who hit 5 threes the last time we covered a Battle Creek game. Interesting starting lineup for Royal Branch tonight, wouldn't you say? As our clock was a little bit off there with the slow start. 7:19 and it's 3-0 Battery. Quick apologize.
Branch is kind of a new starting lineup that they're using here. I don't know what Coach Faber has planned for us tonight, but this is a new starting lineup, and let's see if it works here.
Yeah, Mathis comes up with the steal there on the pass, but it's different for Royal Branch. Battle Creek, their usual starting lineup. Royal Branch has made some changes, most notably KJ Chisholm. He just committed to Jackson State in football. No Gilbert, no LaRon Wright. Spot the chance for Coach Faber and crew. That one goes through the hands of Evans, the 6'8 center. The layup just a little bit short. And picked back up and goes down by Jenkins. Looks like the referee wants to take a moment to talk to Coach Brown. And it looks like something might be outside of his control going on outside of the court. The referee's probably giving him a talk to about. Coach Brown started immediately looking around for somebody. The three ball is up. The 3-point exhibition so far in the first quarter, they got 9 points, all threes, as they're getting through swarms, Tony Lee. And a jump ball.
This Battery Creek crowd is fired up early in the game. Three straight threes for them, getting off to a big lead against Branch here.
defense there. Ethan Cox got the lead, followed by Jenkins. Outside three, it's Cox. Beaufort to 801-801. They have support our coverage of local high school sports. That is Beaufort to 801-801. We are a 501c3 nonprofit organization, specializes in teaching young students about sports broadcasting and offering our coverage to the local high schools in the area free of charge. So all donations help and help us get more equipment and to do things that we do here on the Beaufort Zone to bring you this game alive. Quickly stolen by Well Branch inside. Jenkins going up with it. The whistle call. He'll go to the line, but no bucket. Start here for Battery Creek. Now you would like to see them keep that going, but now 4 threes already in the first 2 minutes of the game, 2.5 minutes. I don't see that trend being able to continue as Jenkins knocks down the second of his free throws. And a quick timeout by Coach Faber to talk some things over and see if he can adjust his defense to slow down that 3-point onslaught here by Battery Creek.
Yeah, and already you can see that the front court, the full court defense here by Whale Branch is way more aggressive. They're looking for turnovers. They're looking to get steals off this team right here.
That court quick pass inside. The pass misses the easy layup. Crowd already started cheering as they thought that was a for sure bucket. Cross court to Evans, back to Lee. And they pass it around the arc here, trying to find room. Lee puts up a three.
And just like that, Well Branch is right back into this game. Another easy two missed here by Battery Creek.
Yeah, Cox is definitely going to want that back this game, back within three already. Even after the onslaught, and thought Evans is going to pull it up there. They kick it. Lee thinks about it, finds Evans on the outside. He puts up a shot, airballs it.
Well, Branch is showing some promising ball movement here to start off the game.
And the three, this time no good from Ethan White on the outside. Lee the man up front. Try a little cut with Tyler Lee. Great defense by Battery Creek. Dropping the inside. The layup is good by Jenkins. On the defense is Lee. He gets the quick steal pass to Jenkins. He lands an easy layup. 2 points for the game. It's tied here on Q. Well, they're getting aggressive up front on Q. Williams gets the pass to Cole. And out of bounds, of course, the turnover. But just like that, Well Branch is right back in it.
Yeah, Creek here, they're normally known for putting the pressure on the defensive side, but Well Branch is matching that energy here. I wasn't quite able to catch the Ridgeland game that they played last Friday, but from my knowledge, I don't think they've played a team that's kind of matched this full court press defense with the same amount of pressure that they have. So it's going to be a tough task for Creek to get over this hump, but I'm sure that both teams are going to be able to adjust.
Quick pass inside to Evans. Evans back to Jenkins. Quickly guarded by Mathis, getting tied up. And that's going to be Battery Creek ball. Leggett checks back into the game for Battery Creek. Williams, the man, standing on the paint, trying to get the inbound pass. He gets it to Mathis. Mathis trying to put on the moves. Here comes the help defense by Evans, and Lee going to get the steal. And the three ball is up and off the rim. And I tell you what, after what we've seen in this first quarter, it's still by Walt Branch. I don't think nobody's going to be shy about putting up a three. Lee taking his time. He's just floating it down. To Cole, and once again, Cox. He's kind of been the subject out of the bright spot has been the three ball for Battery Creek. Cox, two easy layups and a turnover right there. The pass kind of almost straight to him, and he just kind of can't hold on to it.
Yeah, and that's the effect that that pressure will have on you when it comes to this full court defense here. Forcing to make errant passes, even when you feel like nobody's on you, you feel like people are going to rush up to you, because that's what the pressure does.
And Evans, the double team's finding a way to squeeze through. I guess being short, he gets the assist. David Evans, what a play.
And that's been the difference of this game. The two-pointers that Battery Creek has missed is the difference in the score right here. They had two free layups, which would have tied the game right here if they have hit those right there.
Pass to Jenkins, trying to take on Naquan Gordon. Offensive foul will get the man to pass it in. Williams finds Cole, unable to hold on to it. And now going the other way as well, Branch. Inside, Jenkins puts it up. Just a little bit short, Mathis on the defense. He gets the rebound going the other way. Finds Williams, he's put up. Shortest of threes here in the first quarter. What is that, six in total already here in the first quarter combined by both teams. And it's been an exciting one here so far. And let us know how you're feeling in the comments chat. Don't be afraid. Let us get a go Warriors or a go Dolphins for the sister school rivalry here between these two. One-handed catch there, try to pass it back. And it goes into the hands of Mr. White. And foul call on Dorian Austin. Foul by Austin puts Battery Creek inside of the bonus. Now White's going to make the first of two. And he knocks down the second. floater, no good. Here comes Lee with the rebound and pushing the pace. Dribbling in and around traffic before he gets it to Evans, but they're going to say it touched the blue line. Minute of an exciting first quarter. Lee Evans taking turns. Evans trying to make a move. Lee, the corner, the three. No good from Austin. That bounces all around the rim and the backboard. And now White brings across half court for getting it to Williams. Mathis pump fakes the three, drives, shot attempt, no good. Under 30 seconds we go. Lee to Evans, guarded by White. Here comes the help defense by Mathis. Austin decides not to shoot. It's tipped by Williams. And out of bounds, still gonna be a well-branched ball. Just under 10 seconds left to go here inside the first quarter. Driving is Austin, the layup no good. As he was right there at the rim, Mathis puts up a shot, and it's going to be way short. And that's going to be the end of an exciting first quarter. Battery Creek 17, Broadway 16. Welcome back, everybody, inside of the second quarter. My name, once again, Javon Livingston. Alongside me, Mr. Tristan Roberts. The three ball up by Cole there to start the second. No good. Marie Brown, well, branch as Evans brings it across half court. Trying to find some room. He's guarded by Cole. Evans puts up a three. And there goes one for Evans. Another three ball here in this game. And Cole Sutton step in and take a two. Nice pass between the legs by Evans, but nothing comes of it. Trying to find his man, cross court pass there. And in the corner, another three ball. And down it goes.
And Austin, after hitting that three, was talking a little to Leggett there.
Yeah, this is a rivalry game, so you're going to see a little bit of talking here tonight between both of these teams. It definitely could get chippy if the game stays close. It's still on Evans. He's out front. The one-on-one draws the foul. And Evans will go to the line to shoot. I think he's fouled by Williams. knocks down both. Wall Branch up by five. Try to get the pass inside the pole. Well, almost like he lost it. He tries to drive and throw up a shot attempt at the last second, and then it was all the travel on Cole. Austin to Evans, back to Austin, the lead cross court to Evans. David Evans, should I say. Now Isaiah Evans tries to get the turnaround jumper in the post, doesn't get it to fall. In the corner, Cox thinking about it. Almost had an opportunity for a steal there and just misses it. And to the line goes Cole. Did he? I thought he had made that one. I don't know. Misses the first, but makes the second. Cross court to Lee, who jumped for it, wide open at first. Inside, 2 points. It's good, counter for Aaron Fields. Now White trying to go with the underhand layup to Isaiah Evans inside the hole.
And right here, this lineup that Coach Faber has, it's an odd one, that one that we haven't seen all season, but it's working for Royal Branch right here. Seems like they're kind of moving the ball better with this lineup without the starters on the court right here.
Yeah, and I say that, you know, it's 26-20, and Royal Branch doesn't have their starters in. Like, these were the starters on the preseason tournament. These were the starters versus Beaufort High, and now versus Battle Creek. They're not playing, so that says something about the confidence that they have that they can win this game without playing their guys. Their starters aren't in, and then KJ Chisholm is away Jackson State. So three ball, Williams, no good. The rebound, Cole, trying to go back up, draws the foul to the line, here you go.
And that's one thing that Whale Branch has to clean up, those fouls. As you can see on the scoreboard right here, Battery Creek only has one foul in this quarter right here, but Whale Branch has three, and we're only 3 minutes into the quarter. So if they want to stop Battery Creek from getting into this bonus further on later on into this game, they have to clean up on defense, put hands up, and just not reaching over in order to cause the shooting fouls.
Well, it won't be as bad if Cole keeps missing at the free throw line so far. He's one of three. Here comes his fourth attempt at the line.
I gotta say though, Javon, the shoe game that I'm seeing on the court right here from the Dolphins is immaculate.
Hey, listen, the shoe game, I wish we had a shoe cam. I mentioned it a lot last year. That makes Cole 1-for-4 from the line. But I mentioned it a lot. Definitely like to check out the shoe game on the players. Usually good on those free throws. I won't hop on it, but you definitely see some colors here tonight on the Battery Creek side. Inbounds to Isaiah Evans. Can't find room. Gets it to David Evans. Working through the double team. I was going to say nice work, but last touch there by Well Branch, and winds up in a turnover as he maneuvered that double team pretty well until the end.
Yeah, he just had no help to come over and grab the ball from him, so he tried to force a pass into the paint, and it just ended up being errant.
And still coming up with it, Broxton Jr. And high pass falling up trying to get to Austin. Excuse me, not Austin. Aaron Fields.
On defense, it seems like David Evans is almost daring the defenders to go left. Like he's giving up the left side completely to the ball handlers.
That's something, you know, watch film. Maybe he's seen something. Not left-handed shots. Daring to go left with some weak left-handed dribbling. We got a turnover there. Gordon comes up with it, gets it to Mathis. Mathis pump fakes the three, gets it in the corner to Cole. The drive, the floater, no good. Looked like a nice shot there for Derek Smalls.
And you can see the effect that having Isaiah Evans, or as the students call him, Tots, in the paint, because it's almost like the defender is throws off the offensive shot as the starters come in, and it's a standing ovation almost for him.
Maybe he saw something he didn't like from his first string starter and say, hey, we're going to sit you out the first quarter. Or maybe it was confidence. I don't know what it was. But for them to have a 5-point lead more than halfway into the second quarter without their starters in and then to finally put them in and they get a standing ovation here, it says a lot about how good this team is. On the inside, Thompson, you see he quickly goes to the basket, just comes up a little bit short. And the drive. It looks like might be the foul coming there on Q Williams. And they go to the line. Short rebound to Thompson, gets the lead, gets it to Wright at the top of the key. The number point guard, he takes command and dishes it off to Evans. As they start a play, Thompson, Wright going baseline. Gets tripped up there, Battery Creek ball. Up top playing the defense, and that says a lot when you got your big guy guarding at the three-point line and it winds up in the turnover.
And his background from football kind of helps him with that. He's known as an agile defender on the football field, so it kind of helps him in the basketball sense as well.
Yeah, Thompson, he plays on that defensive line there for the Warriors, and it's amazing that when you get to the court and you see how agile he is. He looks like a man amongst boys on the football field, and he's not even the tallest one on the basketball team. He catches the airmail and tries to put it back up. He doesn't get it to go going the other way. Battery Creek guarded by Evans. Cole in the turnover into the hands of David Evans. He's just trying to slow it down, gets it to Wright at the top. Standing on the logo before they decide to get a play call going. Evans puts up a three just a little bit short. And they're going to call the foul on Evans. And they'll go to the line for a three.
And well, Branch, on the defensive side of the ball, starters or not, they've kind of taken away that three from their shooter, Gabe Leggett. Haven't seen him kind of involved in the offense at all. I mean, not even swinging the rock. It's just like, it's almost as they've taken that factor away from Creek in total. And it's kind of messing up their offensive pattern and their rhythm or something.
Started to slow down just a little bit here on both sides here, especially Battle Creek with the most. Maybe some adjustments during the end of the quarter there, but as Evans goes 3-for-3 from the line. Mathis leaves it a little bit short. Wright comes up with the rebound, trying to find some room. Drive the kick to Lee. Nothing there. Lee gets it back to Wright. He puts up a three. Air ball, rebound Thompson. He gets two.
Starters are still trying to get a little loose from sitting out the whole first quarter and almost the whole half. I've seen some offseason clips and I've seen him jamming. Maybe he just wanted to take the easy points there. I don't know.
That's going to be the ball, the foul, team foul there on Gilbert. And to the line goes Mathis as Battery Creek hits the bonus. David Evans getting back on the defense. Sorry, missed a little bit of the excitement there. Getting Mr. Roberts going there. The 2-point is up by Cox. He gets the two. As time rolls down here at the end of the half. Inside to Gilbert on the drive. He gets the lay, not the end one. Yeah, I was trying to get Mr. Roberts ready to do that halftime interview here in a moment. And I believe I hit the wrong button on the column there. It's 33-25 is your score. Scoreboard is fine. Scoreboard is working. I just hit the wrong score button. The wrong button on the scoreboard myself. And just a reminder, our scoreboard is not in sync with the school here, so I manually also have to hit these buttons. I'm also the cameraman and the commentator all in one. Evans for three. That's good. Mathis dumps it off to Cox. He knocks down two. And a pass to Lee, and that's going to be the end of our first half.
gotta be on us.
That's gonna do it. We'll be here right back. Wall Branch 36, Battery Creek 27. Welcome back, everybody, here live with the second quarter. Battle High School Boys Basketball, Well Branch versus Battle Creek. Well Branch had the 5-point lead without their starters into the game. They finally put them in halfway through the second quarter. Now the lead slowly cruised its way up to what you see here, which is 9, as Mathis slashes his way towards the bucket here, but comes up just a little bit short. And he chases that one down. That's another chance, a 3-ball up in the air. And the look might have ran out from the first half as that one comes away short.
And Mathis, one of their better players on the Battery Creek team, hasn't been able to get going in the first half. Him and Leggett both kind of off their game tonight. Let's see if they can get them going, because that's a big part of their offense, being able to knock down the three and having his kind of always at 1,000 pace right here to start pacing the game at the pace that they like.
And the backboard is right. Wasn't able to chase that one down. It was a beautiful catch, but not able to get the toe tap there. It's not. Williams at the top trying to set a play, guarded by Thompson. Battle Creek taking turns, passing around the top of the arc there. Kicks it out cold in the corner. Air ball, Cox the rebound, and the air ball's the layup just as well, and the rebound going the other way for Well Branch. A little bit too high for Gilbert, tried to pull it down, but just couldn't corral it. Bit off target. Quick pass up front to Williams, inside to Gilbert. Try to get one more pass out of it, and driving full court was White. Not able to get it to go.
And it kind of looks like Creek has disbanded or kind of went away from their two-man front, where they're pressuring the ball, they're pressuring the point guard as soon as he hits the ball. It's kind of like a one-man guarding the full court, and then the other two are just sending half court.
Cross court to Evans, pump fakes the three, drive, kick to Gilbert. Quick was surrounded by Dolphins, and Cox gets the rebound. And pass dishes it off to White. White, man, bring across half court. And gives it to Williams. And Williams puts one up, airballs the mid-range shot at the rim. And Cox not able to get the follow. Well Branch ball. Tipped by Cole and hits the wall. Yeah, that's what we thought. I could have swore Cole was the last person to touch the ball. And they were giving it to Battery Creek. A little bit of confusion on the inbound there. And the tip ball going the other way up front is Evans, Trying to chase down to the corner to Lee, right at the top for the three, and just short. Looked like it was going to drop in. And Lee trying to chase it down. And we're going to get a timeout from Coach Faber and crew. Coming over the top. And to the line goes Ethan White. Substitution, Isaiah Evans out, Gregory Gilbert in. In and out, Thompson with the rebound. Lee back to Thompson, gets it to Evans. Cross court, stolen by Wright. He gets the layup to go. Pushing it all the way across court, and Cox getting his hand.
And yeah, this is how bad it. This is how Beaufort High got back into the game last week. Whale Branch had a pretty sizable lead at halftime, and then turnovers, man. Turnovers are costing them. Just the cross court passes that they were able to make in the first half. Battery Creek made adjustments to it. So there.
Well, they're able to get that one by Mr. Jenkins. And they keep that lead up by eight. And let's see if those turnovers wind up plugging the Well Branch here in the second half. Williams trying to find some room to drive through the traffic. And draws a foul there, team foul. And that's gonna be five on Well Branch. Coach Brown trying to argue the fact that the ref didn't use the traditional counter motion. Usually you see the referees when they're counting, they kind of move their hand in and out. And that was stolen by Ethan White, leaping up into the air, up front to Williams, trying to get a handle on it. And that opportunity, might have had an opportunity for a three there, but they're going to reset with Mathis at the top of the key. Looks like he's trying to take on Wright before finally giving it to Cole. Williams. The three, air ball, kicks it right back out to him as right and in, but locked by Gilbert. And the inbound pass. They get it to Cox, and another air ball by Battery Creek. Just safe to say the magic here has kind of ran out there for the three ball. And Gilbert misses the easy lay, but he's got the height advantage going for it. It gets his own rebound.
And the foul called on Mr. Gilbert.
And Williams out, Leggett in. And Wright dribbling around traffic before trying to drop off inside. The steal from Cole gets it to Leggett. Leggett slows it down and finds Mathis. He's now trying to push the pace, driving all the way. And the layup is good. But Elijah Mathis stumbling on his own feet there. And Walt Branch has done a good job of keeping that lead at 6-8 there. Walt Branch hasn't been able to, Battery Creek hasn't been able to close that gap. And the block by Cox is, Gilbert tried to set his feet on the shot. With the rebound, gets it into the hands of Leggett. Once again, passes it off to Mathis. Drive, kicks the Cole. Cole gets the two. And it looks like they called the foul there on Coach Brown. And just gave him a warning, I guess, for giving him a tech. I guess referee not upset with the critique of his officiating here tonight. Lee takes the three and knocks it down. Just when Battery Creek thinks they're chewing down on that lead, Well Branch knocks down the shot to keep them at bay. Well Branch passing around the top of the arc, trying to find some room inside that Battery Creek defense, like they're trying to get the last shot off here of the third quarter. Mathis and Cox on the defense. It gets in the hands of White. He's going to get the steal. And that's going to be the foul on LeRon Wright.
Looked like he was kind of taking out some frustration on that foul there. He felt like he got fouled in the last possession and didn't get called.
I apologize. I don't think I had the clock running there for a moment, but 10 seconds left to go here inside the third quarter. And they stopped the clock here, too. They didn't roll the clock, so it confused me just a little bit. They roll it, run it down to 7. So 7 seconds left on the clock. Battery Creek inside the bonus here. So you see Mathis at the line. Comes up just short. misses the second one. And the air pass still winds up in the hands of Will Branch. And Lee takes his time to stretch one up there at the end of the fourth. We'll be right back for the start of the fourth quarter. Welcome back, everybody. Start of the fourth quarter. It's do or die time. The Well Brent at Battery Creek down by 7 points here to start the fourth. Shout out to Mr. Tell joining us in the chat. Proud of both teams competing here tonight. And a special shout out to Mathis, three ball up by Lee. And Thompson with the rebound, falling a little bit backwards. No travel call. I guess he didn't have possession, but finally winds up in the hands of Battery Creek. Mathis on the drive, jacks one up. And off the rebound, here comes Wright, pushing it the other way. Another tough layup there, no good. Here comes Williams. And it looks like he's going to take his time to try to reset here. As he works his way to the top of the key and back towards the logo. Going to get the foul. And to the
Coach Faber took the little blazer off that he had on earlier in the game.
Yeah, man, sometimes that heat will get to you. Times you come into these arenas, they don't turn the AC on at all, you know what I'm saying, for the athletes, so it can stay a little bit warm, don't want it too cold. So I'm not gonna say don't turn the AC on, but they just got it on high. It might be set to like 76.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The floater, let's go! Lee with 4 points in about 10 seconds there. They left Cole wide open, and he gets the easy two. Travel on Lee. Evans at the top. Mathis decides to take a three, and one it goes. A much needed one for Battery Creek. It's been a while since they knocked one down. They're still down by six. Can't get past it. And now Will Brent's taking their time. Trying to hold on to the lead. Passing their way around the arc. Trying to get it inside. Cox gets a hand on it, going all the way. And he gets through two. Going full court. Big man rumble. Big man rumble. Brett's trying to find some room inside the defense. Wright drives, puts one up, doesn't get it to go. Jabari Cole with the rebound, gets it to Mathis. Matt Williams in the corner, threes off Cole, the rebound, puts it back up, and leaves it short, in and out. Thompson with the rebound, opportunity there for Battery Creek to get it within three. Who's been chasing this Will Brent lead since the first quarter. And Mathis almost got the steal there, but stepped out of bounds. There by Coach Faber. Don't forget, if you enjoy our coverage tonight, you can always text Buford to 801-801. Help support our coverage of local high school sports as we make our way around Beaufort County, covering the local schools in all various sports. We got football, we got volleyball, we've done basketball, we got wrestling coming up, some more tomorrow, and then we got spring sports not too far around the corner. So all your donations will be appreciated to help us continue to do what we do here on Beaufort's own. With the double team there by Williams and Cox. Trying to find some room, puts up the three. And back up the lead goes as Leggett gets it to Cole. And help defense from behind with Kevin Jenkins. Evans was in the front. Easily blocked there. And Dorian Austin was standing there like he was just waiting on that one. The three ball is up, no good from Jenkins. Yeah. body of Creek trying to find some room in the Well Branch defense. And Matthews is going to take it himself high up into the air. With the foul call on Matthews. Evans taking his time, coming past half court, and here comes trap defense there, playing aggressive at the top of half court there. Williams chasing around whoever has the ball, coming in to aid the defense. Well, Brent's done a good job keeping the pass going. Call the travel on Lee's second time tonight. And shout out to Ms. Patel offering the post game donation. Appreciate it so much. And the air pass by Cole out of bounds. He was trying to reach Leggett. Leggett kind of confused as he was a little bit covered there on by the defense. Tip by Cox.
And Javon, I'd just like to mention that before halftime, we were talking about what things that Will Branch can improve on. I said cutting down the fouls and like the turnovers and everything. As you can see, fourth quarter here, they have no fouls so as of yet. And that you see that in the gameplay here. They've been much smoother with the rock and been able to pass the ball more efficiently, play defense more efficiently, and not have to worry about getting creeped into that bonus.
And the crowd going crazy here as Matthews with the drive. Little upset, the three by White, it's off. Scrambling for it on the ground, finally in the hands of Matthews. He gets it to Cole, trying to back down Jenkins. Layup a little bit short there. Well, Brad's ball tosses it up court. Trying to get it to Thompson. Thompson not able to get it to go. Here comes Williams. The offensive foul, drawing the charge, David Evans.
That's what they were missing in that Beaufort High game. Evans wasn't able to hit some of his shots, so just wasn't taking them. The Creek returns the favor with a three of their own as we get a timeout. I'm
sorry. It's all good, man. When the Creek move off the side right there, Brady Creek answers right back. Going to put Well Branch in the bonus, and it's safe to say this lead is kind of safe now. 7 points with just over a minute left. We can't say no knows he's been safe in basketball, a couple of threes, and you know, it's a whole change of pace. But now that Well Branch is in the bonus, they've kind of held on to that lead pretty much from the second quarter on since they got it. And haven't let Battery Creek come within three. So it's safe to say they continue that stroke of luck here with the last minute and a half to go.
And like you mentioned, no lead is safe when you're able to hit the three. And here comes Creek subbing in their best three-point shooter, Gabe Leggett, in order to try to get that started.
Mathis the drive. He drops it off the top. They get two. Gotta pass it up ahead. Air pass into the hands. It goes to Battery Creek. Battery Creek Williams on the drive. No foul. Two defenders going for Williams. Now the Battery Creek fans upset. And now Battery Creek having to go for the intentional foul. Well Branch in the bonus. So to the line goes David Evans. Evans knocks down both of his to pretty much ice the game there. 40 seconds there, 2 points. And another timeout by Coach Brown. Shout out to Talena Webb checking in the chat. The rapper extraordinaire herself. They're from the island.
Touching a foul into the line, Evans goes. With 35 seconds left to go. Corey Green. Talking about what an interesting game has been tonight. And interesting, everybody checks in at the end of the game. Where was the company throughout the whole game? We were looking for the comments.
There goes Keith Chisholm himself in the comments.
AJ out there committed to Jackson State. Congratulations, young fella, for the commitment there. And don't forget, you can check the local Hoop Support podcast tonight, Tuesdays and Fridays at 10 p.m. as they round up all the scores in the local. You can guarantee myself and Mr. Robinson check in there on the local podcast. Don't forget, you can tune in on their Facebook page, localsports.com.
With 30 seconds left to go, Well Branch gets their first team foul of the quarter. And they're in the bonus. Battery Creek has seven playing aggressive, trying to come back.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, Well Branch, like I said, they needed to cut down on those fouls, those turnovers, and they get all the way down. They only got one foul here. They only got one foul here coming in the final seconds. And they knock down one at the line, and Well Branch is just going to buy their time here in the final seconds as they're up by 7. Battery Creek trying to push the pace. And Jenkins puts one up, tried to seal the deal, and coming down, and the travel call on Wise. He thought he secured the steal. And there goes the chance from Well Branch as they come in to the Palace of Boston Hill, Joseph Stroman, Junior Jim, and they get the dub in the first game of the rivalry here. The drive and the layup from Damian Freeman, and another timeout with just 1 second left. Jenkins to do the honors, trying to find some room. He gets Thompson. Thompson misses, but gets the battery creep. Thompson won up, but it doesn't matter. Final results of this game. I forgot to add the free throws. Free throws in there, apologize. 56-51 is going to be the final score here tonight. What an interesting game we have for a crosstown rivalry. I want to thank everybody for tuning in here tonight. My name is Javon Livingston. Alongside me has been Tristan Roberts.